before we start fixing anything, I would like to compare the telephone cable to the network cable. The telephone cable to the Ethernet cable. They have some features in common as related to the locking mechanism. If I take a first look, I see that the Ethernet cable, which is the yellow one, is wider and also longer than the telephone cable. However, at the front, we see a little bump there, about 1/16 of an inch long. And I'm turning this one around so we can compare the bumps. And we can clearly see that they are of the same width, that little bump, that little frontal bump. This is 1/4 of an inch wide. Okay, so the little bump here is a little same as the little bump there, 1/4 of an inch wide. If we turn them sideways, we see that they have a little lever that travels from a stump up front and floats up. And it's the same mechanism that exists here, a little lever. This lever is a little longer than the other lever. As I mentioned before, this plug, telephone plug, is shorter than the Ethernet plug. Translation, which we'll be using shortly, translation, that part that shows the yellow cable cover inside the plug itself, inside the clear plastic plug, will not go into the machine or into the female Ethernet plug. It will stay outside. So the fact that the telephone plug is shorter does not mean that the Ethernet plug travels further inside. They travel the same distance. That 1/4 inch bump that I mentioned is identical in both of them. What else is identical? The lever that's rising and that is connected to the 1/4 inch front is 1/8 of an inch wide. 1/8 of an inch wide here as well, except it's shorter. Now let's see if I can have a clear plug there, since the green doesn't seem to show. 1/8 of an inch clearly enough. Here I have a telephone plug that's also clear, and you can see that the lever gets skinnier from 1/4 of an inch up front, where it starts rising to the left, to 1/8 of an inch. This is the 1/8 of an inch part is the part that you depressed to disconnect. And the 1/4 inch that's making contact with the 1/8 of an inch part is the part that is locking the plug in place. In other words, you would push down on the lever, insert the plug, and release the lever, and the lever travels up and locks itself. Locks itself where? First, I'll do it the same principle applies to the Ethernet cable. So I'll show you in the Ethernet coupling where the lock is engaged. Now, here is where you insert the plug, and you can see the top part is 1/8 of an inch wide. Below that is a 1/4 of an inch wide part. Now you have to look carefully. You can see that there is a lip, right? There is a lip right in the 1/8 of an inch part. So when you depress that part, inside that 1/8 of an inch part, it's actually a 1/4 inch all the way to the top. But when you depress the 1/8 of an inch lever, the 1/4 inch part gets inserted. Then when you let it go, let go of the lever, it springs back up and the 1/4 inch wide shoulder travels up and falls behind that little front wall that narrows the 1/4 inch wide track into a 1/8 of an inch wide track. So that wall is no more than a 1/16 of an inch thick. So that's the way it locks itself in there. Okay? So there is no looking deep inside. You can see a little shadow there showing the wall up front. There is no 1/8 of an inch track going deep inside. It's only a 1/16 of an inch thick wall that partially closes or narrows the gate from 1/4 inch to 1/8 of an inch. So when the lever is released, it snaps in, and I'll snap it in right now with one hand if I can. I'm holding the camera with the other hand. Here we go. I push it in and you'll hear things snapping in. It snaps in. That means behind that little rod, there is a shoulder. I'm trying to push it out and it won't come out until I press down on this, and here it goes. And it works the same in the telephone connector. Is a female plug, and here you can clearly see that bump there. All right. Start with a piece of plastic that is no wider than 1/4 of an inch. It can't be wider because there is no space for it. And no longer than 1 3/4 inches. At the nine-sixteenth point, we put the mark. That mark we'll use to bend the plastic. So I'm going to bend the plastic right now. I put the pliers right along the mark and bend it. Okay? And the piece of plastic is bent. Okay, now I'm going to keep the bent part flat and bend over the rest of it, so the bent part will be in the middle, sandwiched in the middle. And when I finish bending twice, I'm left with something that looks like that. All right, we have a folded part in the middle and the part on top that looks like it's lifted. The folded part in the middle will be acting as a spring, lifting the part that the pliers are holding, which is the handle. Now we take this as is and I'll go get the Ethernet cable that needs fixing. I found one here that is ready. So the plan is to install this piece of plastic right here on the Ethernet cable. So the part that is on the other side, the part that is lifted will go towards the cable itself, all right, and the part that is bent will go against the stump that is left after the original tap broke off. So I'm going to get a little crazy glue and I'll try to apply the crazy glue at the bottom of the clip. Okay, make sure that the crazy glue is flowing. Yep, a dab of it. I put that all around the bottom. Then I approach the clip and push it down. Now I don't want to trap my fingers, so I'll use the pliers to push it down up front. Make sure it's very centered. And add pressure. Add a little pressure in the back as well. So this thing will be stuck there permanently. I'll find a coupler and insert the clamp into the coupler in a few seconds. Hold on. I'll let this sit by itself there for now. All right. And give you a profile look as well. Here's what we've accomplished. Now this thing will work by friction alone. I found the plug. And we will insert into the plug. The plug is down there. And we just insert it in. And it's a fit. It's inserted there. You can see the piece right there. You press on it and you release and you insert and it stays there pretty good. You can shake that. It's not going anywhere. It's a good connection. An excellent connection. The increased friction will keep the connection secure, and the advantage also, if somebody kicks the wire and if the thing eventually comes out, nothing will break. So let me take it out here again and put it back. There is no clicking because there is no lock, but it's very tight friction. It works perfect if you ask me. All right, and the plastic for that came from an old juice bottle. Plastic is usually thicker than soda bottle plastic.